start recording.
Cool. Yeah, where's their level at, roughly?
I don't know. They said, like, in 4-ish was their estimate. So that would be fine for this club if they're, like, deep in 4. Yeah. And Cookie kind of dropped off, so it's always nice to have that.
Mm-hmm.
So we left off with Nebody handing over the strange magical sealing device back to Khan. And so Khan thinks, Mitame yori mo omokute nantonaku iyana kanji desu. So it feels heavier than it should be by like what you by your eyes looking at it. And it kind of gives off a bad feeling to Khan. And then your turn.
Sure. Just looking up some words in there.
Mattaku zensaku zumi na kozou me. Yawari wa yashiki no hoka no heya ni hairikonda ore ni sukoshi sekkyō shite kara zensaku zuki no batsu toshite ore ni totte wa kore kurai zensaku eri のうちに入らないんだけど、ベネットが割った大量の叩きを一階の物置に入れるようと命令した。
Okay, what's going on here?
So, sensaku means inquisitive.
So,
a busybody.
I see. Cool. Put that in. All right, we're in chapter 11 now, aren't we?
Hi.
So, different folder for me. Okay, so, yeah, he says, like, man, you really are noisy, boy. And he, it's like Kyo's lecture, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So, he lectures me, who, you know, went into the room. And as punishment for being nosy,
The punishment's this part.
I don't know what to make of the... Yeah, the
this is what the punishment is. This is his opinion on basically being called Sidsaku.
Mm.
So he's like, it's punishment. And he's like I need punishment or something like that. And the actual punishment's over here.
I see. Yeah, it makes sense. But this remark that he's making about this punishment, he's saying that it, like, my sensaku wasn't that bad, so bad to warrant such punishment.
Yeah.
Right? Is that the idea? Cool. So, as the punishment, can you think about what this is?
Probably to do with Tataki.
Oh, I see. He tells me to put the wood that had been cut up by Bennett. He tells me to put it in the storage room on the first floor.
Hi. Tashikani, I always forget the phrase. Monooki. Tashikani monooki ni irete okeba ame ni nurenai shi asa Bennett ga daidokoro no danro ni takigi o kuberu toki mo 1階にあれば持ってくるのが楽だ。 So it's certainly true that if I put the firewood inside of the storehouse, that it won't get wet. And when the morning comes, when Bennett goes over to start a fire, if it's on the first floor, then it would be quite a bit easier for him.
Cool.
焚き木を全部運んでから詳細に戻った。ネバリーは椅子に座り、翼のついた砂時計の絵が表示に記された本に目を通した。
So, when I, once I had taken all of the wood to, just once I had carried it all, I returned to the office, and Nebari was sitting in a chair. And looking over a book with a hourglass with wings on the cover.
Hi. 全部ちゃんと入れといたよ。疲れたし、降り続けていた雨に服が濡れ、体も冷えてしまったので、炎、or is it he in this case? He, 火が赤々と燃える暖炉に近づいた。So he's like, I properly put them all in, which would be inside of the storehouse. I was really tired, and my body was sopping wet from the rain that was continually falling. So because of that, I was really, really cold, like my body as well. So because of that, I got closer to the fireplace with the fire that was burning in it. In the aka aka, which was a very red fire, I guess.
ネバリーは本から顔を上げなかった。よかろう。他の仕事を見つけろ。
So, Nevery doesn't lift his face up from his book. Says, good. Go find some other work.
はい。さ、ネバリー。感じかんだ手を火にかざして声をかけた。石について聞きたいことがあるんだけど。Nevery, I asked, as I believe it's probably really cold. Yep, to grow numb. As I place my hands, like I'm warming them, I'd guess, to hold aloft. So I was holding my hands over the fire, and my hands were numb from the cold. And then I said, about the rocks, I have a question I have about it.
ネバリーは勢いよく本を閉じた。仕事場、or was it 仕事場?
I think it's ba. Yep, 仕事場。
Yep, sure is.
So, 仕事場で見つけたという石のことか。
So, hold on a second, I wanted to double check the meaning for 仕事場。
I see.There's like another really similar word to this that we've seen.
Isn't there?
Something like a workroom?
Yep. They use like, I feel like,
anyway. Do you
recall
what it was? I don't know.
I don't recall. But it's kind of like they want to use, you know, different vocab words. But we've definitely have seen something
For
similar
sure.
to that.
Mm-hmm. So, Nevery forcefully closes the book. You're talking about the rocks in the work you found in the workroom?
俺はうなずき。暖炉の前にあぐらをかいて座った。あれって窓先だよね? So I nod and I put myself to sit crisscross applesauce in front of the fireplace. Those are magical stones, right? That's for you.
無論だ。ネブリは少し間を置いて続けた。持ち主の魔術師は全員塔に死んでおるかなと読んでいた本を手に取る。
So he says, of course. Nevery paused for a moment and then continued.The owners of them all died a long time ago, though, he said as he closed or took the book into his hand.
はい。これは我が一族の歴史をまとめたのものだ。This is basically collects all of the history of my family.
先祖の魔術師の名前とそれぞれの魔導石のことがすべて書かれておる。
So basically what's written in here is basically all about the different magical stones in here and the names of my ancestor magicians.
俺は暖炉の火を見つめた。じゃあ、 コツコツした石のしかめ面のあごひげ男も、青い水晶のかけらの恥ずかしそうな女の子も、みんな死んじゃったのか。There's what I want to look up in there. ゴツゴツ。
That was the rough.
Ah, rugged.
That was the rough, yep.
Yeah. Yep. Cool. So he goes, and so Khan stares into the fire. And he says, well, Shikametsura. I have to look that up.
I think it's scallion face in my guess. Yep.
Yep, that's correct. So the scowling bearded man and from the rough stone, or of the rough stone, and the shy girl of the blue shard of the crystal, all of them are dead, huh?
Nabiri ga tsurudoi me tsuki de ore o mita. Nanda kozo, sensaku tsuki no omae no koto da. Ishi ni sawatta no dearou. So Nebody looks at me with his sharp eyes, and he says, "What boy? You're such a busybody. I bet you actually touched the stones."
Ore wa tameiki o tsuita. Haeiro no robu o kita onna no hito ga ichiban suki datta na. Haeiro no ローブを着た女の人だと、とネバリーが繰り返す。So he says, yeah, I sighed. My favorite one was the woman wearing the gray robe. A woman wearing a gray robe, you say? Nebri repeated.
うん。河原にあるような、平べたい石を持ってた人、優しく微笑みかけてくれたんだ。 Yeah, the person that possesses the rock that was flat, kind of like a river stone, she gave me a really kind smile.
ネバリは座ったまま身を乗り出し、俺の顎を掴んで自分の方を向かせ、ガミガミと怒鳴った。小僧、適当な嘘を突き寄って。There's a word I have to look up in there. ガミガミ。It's like always the onomatopoeias.
Huh.
I see.
Grabby, grabby.
While sitting, the Yomi-chan's still blocking it on.
Sorry.
Waiting for it to... Okay, there we go. Cool. So, no worries. So he leaned forward while sitting, and he grabbed my chin, and he kind of like made me look at him. And, man, I already forgot what Kamiyami was. In a nagging way, right?
Yeah.
And he yelled at me in a nagging way, and he says, boy, he's saying you're telling lies.
Yes.
Right. Actually, the word tekito is one that I've been struggling with to comprehend.
I guess in this case it'd
Do you know that word well?
Not really, but makes sense. Such a sloppy lie.
Yeah. The thing is, like, if it has, yeah, like I think it's one of those words that just means like extent, like kagen.
Makes sense.
Where it doesn't really mean anything by itself, because like all the definitions of tekito are like contradictory to each other.
So yeah, it's kind of like how like amari as well, like words like that that are like extent words, they tend to be like
yeah, it just means extent.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a lot of words meaning extent in Japanese when I think about it. Dake kurai hodo
tanoma. Ore wa mabataki o shite ato zusaro to shita kedo Nebri no te kara nogare rare nakatta. What? I blinked and I tried to step back. However, Nebri would not let me escape because his hand, you know, was still holding my face.
Kozo, uso de wa nai no ka? Uso nante tsuite nai yo. So he says, boy, that you weren't lying? I wouldn't do something like lie.
Perfect. Nice. And then the other one's like, uso tsuite. Oh, wait, never mind. Wait. So you'll be getting the first line once you can see it.
I can see it now. Nebari wa yoyaku te o hanashi, ore o niranda mama, isu ni fukaku suwari noshita.
So, Nebari finally released his hand and stared at me, or while staring at me, sat deeply, like, how should I say this? Yeah, I guess it's, well... This is a hard thing to convey one idea, but he sat deeply in his chair, but that sitting was readjusting his sitting.
Yeah. I think it's kind of like, you know, when you collapse into your chair. I think it's that kind of resitting. Because he's now sitting because before he basically was leaning out of his chair.
Because so he was, Mio dashed it.
So since he's basically now
sitting, so he goes back in.
Yeah. But the fukaku, I think, is kind of just insinuating the collapsing into a chair. Like you're just like, oh, type of, you know.
Yeah.
That'd be my guess.
Yeah, I can see that. Yeah, that makes sense.
Ore wa neburi no te ga todokanai giri giri no tokoro made awatete sagatta. So I basically I stepped back in like a hurry to be out of where nobody could reach me. In a giri giri kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
Forcefully.
Yeah, I think strongly. It's just barely where he couldn't reach.
Yes. It's literally just the place where he couldn't reach me.
Mm-hmm, but just barely. That's the giri giri.
Mm, yeah.
Like just out of his reach.
So.
Madouseki to sono mochi nushi nitsuite kono hon de yonda no de wa arumai na.
So, So, you haven't read about magic stones and their owners from this book, have you?
Chigau yo. Mietanda. Ishi ni suwatta toki ni. That's wrong. I saw them at the when I touched them. When I touched the stone.
Oh, mietada to? Chitsu ni omoshiroi. Hanashite miyo.
He says, oh, you saw them, you say. That's truly interesting. Tell me about it.
Yōkai. Subete no ishi ni tsuite sawatta toki ni kanjita koto ya mita mono o setsumei shita. So, understood. I basically explained everything that I saw and felt after I touched those stones. So basically I also told him everything about those stones.
Nebari wa tokidoki ore no hanashi o saegiri hon wo mite unazuite kara saki o unagashita. Aza no you na murasaki no ishi o osowareta hanashi mo shita.
Okay, actually I have to look up a few words in here. Where is it?
Saegiru.
That's the interrupt.
Cool. And then,
Unagashita was my guess?
Unagashita. It's to, like, urge, right?
Yes.
And then, Aza.
That was the bruising birthmark we saw last time.
Yep. Okay. So... Nebri would sometimes interrupt my story, look into the book and nod, and then he would urge me to continue. I also told him about the stone that was purple like a bruise that attacked me.
Ano ishi naraba arieru na. If it's that stone, I believe it. Sandai mai no o oba aruya no madoseki datta no ishi. That was the stone that belonged to Aru, whatever that name is. And she was my grandmother, basically, but three generations ago. So my great-great-great-grandmother would be, I guess. Ano oba no madousaki o sawatte sono teido de sundatto wa unga yokatta da ukatta na. So the you were lucky that only to that extent happened when you touched the stone. So only just like the stone being angry, basically, no killing it like Nebri stone wanted to do.
I think you skipped a line. The one starting with Kisho.
Kisho, I definitely did not read that. Kisho ga kanari hageshii hito datta rashii. Her temperament was quite harsh. She was a human. It seemed like she was a human with a very harsh temperament.
Ishi ni tsuite hanashita ato, ore wa dando no hi o nagame, nebari wa hon wo parapara to mekuri.
So after talking about the stones, I stared at the fire, and Neburi was flipping through the pages. I'm going to double check parapara, because I don't recall it at the moment.
I would say it's flipping, pattering noise, but here's the flipping rustling. Book sound.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. So he was, going through the book pages, and... we sat in silence together.
Yep.
For some time.
Yagatte neburi ga sekki barai o shita. Before long, neburi cleared his throat. Suru ni wakatte oru to omou ga, madoseki wa mochinushi no seikaku o hanei suru. So, I'm sure you understand this by now. However, magical stones, they reflect the personalities of their owners. Ishi no warui, yowai, majutsushi no madousaki wa boroku te koware yasuku, katachi o tamotsu no mo muzukashiku naru. So magical stones that belong to wizards who have a weak will, their stones tend to break easily and are fragile. So because of that, it is very hard to preserve the shape of those stones. Hantai ni, ishi no chioi majutsushi no ishi wa katai. On the other hand, wizards with very strong wills have very hard stones. Okay, this will be your page.
なるほど。 確か、 粘りの 窓石 は かなり 硬くて、 鏡の ように 磨き上げられて、 滑らかだった。 しかも、ものすごく危険だった。 滑らか。 I have to look up.
I think that's smooth, but I don't know for sure.
It is.
Nice.
So he says, I understand. Neburi's magical stone is certainly hard, and it's like polished like a mirror and smooth, right? Moreover, it's very dangerous.
Nani se neburi no pocketto kara nusunda okage de ano ishi ga hanatsu kori to kaze ni makikomare ayauku korosare kaketan dakara. Because thanks to the fact that I stole it from his pocket, that stone was able to attempt to kill me, and had some wind and released some ice that surrounded me. say.
Yep. Nebari ga hito iki tsuite chiratto ore o mita. Kozo o kiite oru ka?
So Nebari takes a breath and looks at me with a glance. He says, "Boy, are you listening?"
Ore ga unazuku no mite, Nebari wa hanashi o tsuzuita. So seeing that I nodded, Nebari continued his story. Madoshi no madosaki wa michibata ni ochite iru kōichi no koto mo areba ōba no ishi no you ni kōka na hoseki no koto mo aru. So the stones that belong to magicians, some of them are small stones that you could just find fallen on the side of the road. Other times you will see huge stones that have large amount of value and are crystals. Here's another areba that you rarely ever see, but we've
seen. Know, I was thinking the same thing.
See it again.
Yeah. This translator likes it. I'll read.
だが、魔導石が高価の宝石というのは、実に稀で、恐ろしい事態を、招くと言われている、言われておる。そして、魔導石は持ち主の魔術師の、なぜだ、死後
Yeah, definitely 死後。
Yep. の死後もその性格を保ち続けるものなのだ。
So, but a magical stone that is a valuable jewel is rare. And it is even said that, I guess there's no even, but it is said that they bring about, or rather beckon, a scary situation.
Hi.
Right. So, and even after the owner's death, they retain their character.
はい。窓先が壊れることってあるのか? So what does it mean when a magical stone breaks?
I think he's saying, are there times when they break?
I guess since it's koto ga aru in this, I was thinking this.
Yeah.
The existence of breaking stones, I guess the aru would make that, yeah.
The aru makes it that he's not asking for a definition, but.
I was thinking it's more definition since context. We've already been told that, yeah, these kind of stones are less likely to break, so.
So it is a weird question for him to ask, I agree. But yeah, and then the way he answers also confirms that. Anyways, まあ、ないではない。もし魔術師が魔導石の限度を超える魔術を使おうとしたら壊れるであろう。その場合は魔術師本人も死ぬ。
It says, well, it doesn't not happen. I'm gonna look up 限度. I'm sure it's something like
that. That's the limit, yeah.
Yep, cool. So if they try to use a spell that goes past the limits of the stone, then it will likely break. In those situations, the magician also dies.
Wow, 面白い。ネブリがこういう話をしてくれるのは、俺が間違いなく弟子になった証拠だ。Wow, how interesting! The fact that Nebari is giving me this kind of story must mean that he's definitely is proof that he's definitely made me into his apprentice. Okay, are you good with doing another page? It's 7:43.
I think we should stop.
Okay, we'll stop here then.
Oop. How much left is there of the chapter?
Looks like two more pages. So we have... If I did a full screen, it's... It would be the diary and then this page. And then we're done with that chapter. And then chapter 12. And then we're at the end of my Anki Dick. And I will be really bad.
Wow. Well, probably not too bad. There's not too much new words.
Knowing all the vocab. True.
Yeah, you'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
It'll just be whenever there's an onomatopoeia, we both won't know it.
So.
yeah, it's exciting. We'll probably finish that next time.